We need a 100 and a new one. Yes.
They are.
How? 我知道大家就觉得很无聊，不跟你讲数学无聊是因为我把它变了。那这些东西是这样，我说一个东西变成十倍，然后第二天又变成十倍，这个倍，它就是数学上大家都知道叫 order of magnitude， magnitude 就是大小，那 order of magnitude 数量。 它是100倍就是等级的啊，还是1000倍这个等级的，就最有概念。所以我今天下礼拜把你加薪100倍，然后后再下个月呢，变又降为千分之一倍。如果我常常在做这种倍数这种东西的时候，你用脑子去想就已经很难想了，直觉。可是你用数学来算的话，就很直观。所以数学这个意思，它把你的概念抽象化以后，变得可以算。 才能往前走，你在这边要强，emphasize。我要强调一点，就是说，有的时候当你在做高等物理的时候，其实就在做数学。那你做到后来得到一个答案，如果你的中间过程没有错的话，就要相信这个答案，因为中间已经是用数学的法则去算，你不能再用讲故事的方式去一样一样去描述。 数学是最精简的，它就去描述故事可以算，这很重要。所以这个东西它还是都用乘法嘛，它来个加法嘛，就是正方。啊，数量级去加一个东西是100倍，再加上一个一，也加跟没加一样，对不对？诸如此类，对。
You can make small mistakes when you divide 4 by 1.5, but please don't make mistake when you subtract 19 from 26, because that's a big change. So this number is very important. If this is 5, that's 4 is important. But this is, if this is 2.5, lower 2.5 is a better answer than that. That's kind of scary. So again, please don't do that in your mathematics class, but you can show me that one. So probably you memorize this number. So this number is the energy that sun releases in 1 second. 4 × 10^26 joule. And this is the energy consumption in Japan in the year. I'm sorry, I couldn't find the energy consumption in Taiwan. Probably by factor of huge more. And this is different by factor of 30 meters. What does it mean? So this is how to feel extremely large or extremely small value that we also encounter in being. And this is one example. So the velocity of the sun, this is a 1 second. And this is a 1 year. So if Japan continue to keep this energy, continue to use this energy for 30 million years, then that becomes the same energy as the sun emits 1 second. So now you have some better feeling, right? Because just looking at this number doesn't say much. 26 or 0, wow. But if you do this kind of calculation, you can slightly have a bit better feeling. And this is what we really need to do. Otherwise, it's so big or so small to feel the energy. The sun is extremely bright, extremely luminous. And the energy is something like that. So So if the Japan or Taiwan keep using that energy for 20 million years, it's still 1 second.
所以我觉得很好，太阳一秒钟产生的能量就够日本用2000万。好了，我们听完了。对不起，当老师嘛，你觉得想说坐在台下应该想什么事情？应该想，可以想，说那台湾的耗电量一年是多少？功课可以不做，然后做完以后再去想。 太阳自杀一秒钟向四面八方发射，那我们在地球这个位置拦截到太阳多少量光，对不对？拦截到多少比例？就我们有多少东西拦截到多少这么多能量？除非我们到别的地方去放太阳能板，否则我们拦截不到。在地球上这么一个面积拦截到的能量，我们又布满了多少太阳能板？我们把拦截到的总能量。
用掉的多少？各位，你以为觉得这个也许没有相关有啊？我们国家要发展太阳能的时候，你就要这些数字啊。我们把这栋大楼全部楼上全部布满太阳能板，能够发挥到多少功效？这些都是相关的数字。交给我们说的。是，这个朋友。Yeah, yeah. Okay, so the question. Do you know why does the sun shine? Does the sun shine? Or why the sun is so red, so bright? You have two choices. One is a chemical reaction. The other is a nuclear reaction. If you think A, please raise your hand. A, chemical reaction. Nuclear reaction. Okay, thank you. What's the difference of these two? What's the difference of these two? Yes. That's extremely good answer, so please use
Michael. Anything you have.
That's right, thank you so much. So, this creates new energy. And this is just the element is still the same, elements are still the same. But chemically different because this is body. That's extremely good question, right?
Thank you. 田中老师问说这两种是不一样，左边是化学反应，右边是核反应，有什么差别？回答得很好，说化学反应没有产生新的元素，但是粒子要变成一个分子，对吧？碳还是碳，氧还是氧，那右边就不一样了，那四个氢经过重重力得出的反应呢？
Did you run structural level? Yes. Yes. Do you know proton? Neutron. Electron.
Spin.
You are educating me. Yeah, I can write the Chinese character. So, structure of atom is looks like this. So, for hydrogen, there's a proton, one proton, the center, and the electron, N2, is orbiting around. For helium, we have two protons and two neutrons. And two in four. And this is called the nucleus.
The other one.
But he said, chemical reaction does not change this one. Hydrogen is always hydrogen, carbon is always carbon. But nuclear reaction is something, some change in the nucleus, And that changes a kind of element. So, your answer already, you already said the answer. So this is no change of element, this is a change of the element. And what is happening in the sun is nuclear reaction. Why do you know that? Many of you actually raise your hand for me. Why did you know the sun is, the nuclear reaction is happening in the sun? Why did you know? You already said, no? So actually, probably you have seen, you have read textbook. But actually, this was a big mystery in 100 years ago. No physicist, no. Actually, some people seriously thought about chemical reaction in the sun. So at that time, this was a big problem. But now, many of you actually know this is a nuclear reaction. But what is important here is why we know this is happening. And actually, the key person is Albert Einstein. And according to his theory, the mass can be the energy source. Mass is equivalent to the energy. That's something we cannot expect in daily life. But probably you have seen this equation, yeah? Yes? Have you seen this equation? Oh, yes. Thank you. So what does this mean? Energy and mass, and C is the velocity, speed of light. And this looks nothing to do with each other. But now we know for hydrogen is heavier than one helium. For hydrogen is heavier than one helium. And roughly speaking, what is happening in the sun is formed. Four hydrogen gets together and becomes helium. But then some small fraction of mass is lost because these are heavy. This is light. And where do such energy go? This equation tells that difference in mass can be energy. Probably you cannot believe that. I cannot believe that. Because I do not feel this equation in my daily life. But this is actually true. Many physicists actually prove this is true. So question. This is extremely difficult. But if you have a notebook, you can calculate that. Even if you cannot do that, please don't care. This is so difficult. But let's calculate how much energy is released when making 1.000 kilogram of helium, starting from 1.007 kilogram of hydrogen. Then 0.007 kilogram can be converted to energy. Now you have everything. Difference in mass and light, speed of light. Probably I have to keep this speed of light. So speed of light times 10 to the 8 meter per second. And the hydrogen was 1.007 kilograms. And this goes to helium for 1.000 kilograms. So 0.007 kilogram is lost as an energy. So let's calculate energy. We just multiply mass and velocity. Happy to show your answers to everybody.